Welcome to our science class. So, in our previous, now we are learning about second chapter. Our second chapter is fractions, decimals, and rational numbers. We have completed fractions. Next, we have decimals. So, already we have learned about decimals in our previous class. What is decimal? Where we get decimal? How to write the decimal? How to read the decimal? How to write the expandation form of the decimals? We have learned. Once again, we will recall. Decimal point, now see here. Decimals, we are learning about decimals. Decimals, here we got the decimal numbers. While we are moving from left to right, we will get the decimals. That means, while we are reading the place values, then we will read the place values from right side to left side, place value will increase by 10 times. In the same way, when we go to the place values from right side to left side, the same place value, when you come from right side to left side, it multiplies 10 times. The same place value, when we go to the left to right, it divides by 1 by 10 times. When it's divided by 1 time, 1 by 10 times, we'll get the decimal numbers. If we 1 by 10 times divide on the number, standard decimal numbers aside. In the decimal numbers, we have two parts. One is decimal part, one is whole number part or integral part. After decimal number, we have to read the digit as one whole number. For example, if I have written 170.146, if I have taken this number, now this point divide this number into two parts. This point divide the number into two parts. The point for this point, one number is right side, another number is left side. The number which is left side is called decimal part. Decimal part. The number which is right side to the point is called, so left side. It is right side, the part which is right side is called decimal part. The part which is left side is called whole number part or integral part. Whole or integral part. Whole number part or integral part, and this point is called decimal point. This point is called decimal point. Now we can read this number as 970.146. 970.146 you have to read. 976.146. Now remember here. Observe here. After point I am reading one number. Point after that I am reading one number. Directly 146 and chapter. I am not saying that. That is 146. After point I am explaining as, I am reading as one digit. I am reading, I am saying that 146. Before point I said 970. I have combined these numbers. 970.146. These we have learned in our previous class. It is decimal part, it is whole number part, and this point is called decimal point. Then we have learned expandation form also. After point, same number, we will take another number, same. 560.093. For example, if I have taken this, then how to read this number? 560.01093. This 093 is decimal part, this 560 is integral part or whole number part, that is decimal point. Then how to write the expandation form for this number? Now the point is in middle. The point for this point 560 is left side. Now how to write the expandation form for this 560? Before point, point in mundu. That means the part which is in left side. That is, in that part the place values are starts from 1's place onwards. That means place values moves from right to left. Before point, place values are starts from 1's place onwards. So here we have to move from right side to left side. 1's 10's 100. So the expandation form of 560 is 500 plus 60 plus 0. It is the expandation form of 560. Then when you go to the after point the place values are moved from left side to right side. Point kada the place values second move the left to right. Here. After point the place values are starts from left to right, and The place values are starts from tens onwards. Not ones place. Tens place onwards. Here you did not say TES, TENS. TES and TENS and Chapakudu. How to say Ela Chapalana? TEL, THS. Tens. You have to pronounce TH. I said already. Tens. Hundreds. Thousands. You have to pronounce TH. You have to pronounce TH. Then how to write the expectation form? The expectation form of 093 is, if you have 0, you can, if you want to write, write, otherwise no need. 0 by tens, 9 by hundreds, so you have to write 100, 3 by thousands, so you have to write 1000. It is the difference between expectation form of after point, before point, and this is decimal part, whole number part, integral part we have learned. And we have learned how to come. Okay, it is correct. Then we will learn about comparison of decimals. Here we learn about comparison of decimals. I said already, but I did not explain by clearly. Comparison of decimals. How to compare the decimals? For example, if I have written these numbers, I have written these two numbers on the board. Now, can you see out of these two numbers what is a greater number and what is a smaller number? To find the greater number and to find the smaller number, what we have to do? First of all, we have to count the digits in the given number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It is a 7-digit number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It is also a 7-digit number. In the given numbers, both the digits are same. If the digits are same, what you have to do? You have to compare the first digit. What is the first digit? 2. Here also first digit is 2. If the first digit is same, then you have to compare the second number, it is 7, it is also 7. Then compare the third digit, 0, 0. Fourth digit, 4, 1. Fourth place digits are different. Here the fourth digit is 4, here the fourth digit is 1. So both are not same. Out of the two numbers, 4 is a greater number, so it is a greater number, it is a smaller number. So if it is a normal number, if it is a whole number, you have to compare like this. Then if it is a decimal, then how to compare that number? ఒకవేళ డెసిమల్ అయితే ఎలా కంపేర్ చేయాలి సో దట్ ఈస్ కంపారిజన్ ఆఫ్ డెసిమల్స్ ఐ హావ్ రిటన్ నౌ సీ ఐ యామ్ టేకింగ్ బోత్ ఆర్ డెసిమల్ నెంబర్స్ దట్ ఆర్ 37.970 38.463 దీస్ టూ డెసిమల్స్ ఐ హావ్ టేకెన్ నౌ హౌ టు కంపేర్ దీస్ డెసిమల్స్ If you want to find the greatest number and smallest number in the given decimals, you have to compare the before point numbers. That means you have to compare the whole number part. Integral part you have to check. Integral part you check just for. In integral part, what is the first digit? 3. What is the first digit? 3. If the first digit is same, then you have to compare the second digit. What is the second digit? 7. What is the second digit? 8. If the second digits are same, no, the second digits are different. Here we have 7, here we have 8. So out of these two, 8 is a greater number. So 38.463 is a greater number. Like this you have to compare. Understand? More one. Now see. Before point number you have to check. Is the before point, what is the first digit? 1. What is the first digit? 2. Now see, here also before the digits, the second number is 2, but here we don't have the second number. You can compare like this also. And if all the digits are equal, then you have to compare the digits. Before point here we have only 1 digit, before point here we have 2 digits. So which number is greater number? 1 digit number or 2 digit number? 2 digit number is a greater number. So here we have 1.9784, here we have 12.863. So here first digit is 1, here also first digit is 1. If the first digit is same, then you have to compare the second number. Second digit 2. Here but we don't have the second digit. Ikkada undi kabatti it is a greater number. So 12.863 is a greater number. Like this you have to compare. More 1. Now compare these two. 374.860, 3789.603. 603. Now I want to compare these two and I want to find which is a greater and which is a smaller. Now before point, first number is 3, first number is 3. Second number is 7, second digit is 7. Third digit is 4, third digit is 8. Which is a third, is the third digits are same? No, third digits are different. Here the third digit is 4, here the third digit is 8. So out of these two, 8 is a greater number. So 3789.603 is a greater number. When you compare it, 3374.860. It is comparison of decimals. Like this you have to compare. Okay? Then, next, addition and subtraction of decimals. 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 How to do addition for decimals? How to do subtraction for the decimals? Now see here. 73.460 plus 970.146. Now I want to do addition for these two decimals. How to do addition? Now if you want to do addition, 73.460. Then 970.146 here. Based on the place values you have to write. What is the ones place? Ones place number should be ones place number 0. You have to write there the 0 plus 1 before point. I was writing here before point. Tens place 7, tens place 2, tens place 100 place you have to write as this. If you don't have any number, then don't write anything. You have to leave like it only. 970. Point you get at the same place. Point at the same exactly place. Next 146. 146. Now do add. Add them. 0 plus 6, 6, 6 plus 4, 10, 0 here, 1 will become carry, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 1, 6, 0, 3 plus 0, 3, 7 plus 7, 14, 4 here, 1 will become carry, 9 plus 1, 10. So the answer of 73.460 plus 970.146 is 1043.606. Like this, if I do addition, more than 1.45. Plus 22.346 plus 793.8305. Then add 1.45. Now after before point here in the ones place you have to so you have to write one the ones place only. Tens place, point, point you get straight 3, 4, 6. Next. Third number 793.8305. 793. What do you have in the ones place? 3. 1's plus 3. 10's plus 9. 1's plus 2. 1's plus 10's plus 2. 10's plus 100's plus 7. Then 0.8305. Here you have to do addition. In the addition or subtraction, if you want to do. What you will do, MJSR, and if the digits are not sufficient, then you simply can keep the zeros. Madam, if your digits are equal to level of zeros, bet coach one time, bet the coach one. All the digits are same. Here and here we have zero. Why we have to keep zeros? Zeros and the bet call, because if you add zero to any number or any number to zero, you will get the same number as answer. ఏదైనా నెంబర్ కి జీరో ని యాడ్ చేసినా జీరో కి ఏ నెంబర్ ని యాడ్ చేసినా సేమ్ నెంబర్ ఆన్సర్ వస్తుంది కాబట్టి ఇఫ్ యు వాంట్ టు కీప్ కీప్ అదర్వైస్ నో నేమ్ ఇఫ్ యు వాంట్ టు రైట్ ఇఫ్ యు వాంట్ టు పుట్ ద జీరో దెన్ పుట్ ద జీరో అదర్వైస్ ఇఫ్ యు డోంట్ వాంట్ దెన్ డోంట్ పుట్ ద జీరో దెన్ యాడ్ 0 ప్లస్ 0 0 0 ప్లస్ 5 ఇస్ 5 0 ప్లస్ 6 6 5 ప్లస్ 4 9 9 ప్లస్ 3 2 and 2 1 will become carry 4 plus 1 5 5 plus 3 8 8 plus 8 16 6 here 1 will become carry 1 plus 1 2 2 plus 2 4 4 plus 3 7 0 plus 2, 2, 2 plus 9, 11, 1, 1. 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 1, 1 plus 0, 1, 1 plus 7, 8. The answer is 870.62565. It is addition. Then how to do subtraction? Then subtraction of decimals. 72.568 minus 68.494. For example, if you have like this, then do addition. 72.568 minus 68.494. 68. ones place, tens place, 0.494. 8 minus 4 is 4. Is 6 minus 9 is possible? No. Then what you have to do? You have to take borrow. 10, 16. 16 minus 8 is 9. Sorry, another 7. 16 minus 9 is 7. 5 becomes 4. 4 minus 4 is 0. Is 2 minus 8 is possible? No. Then take borrow. It is 12. 12 minus 8 is 4. 7 will become 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. So the answer of 72.568 minus 68.494 is 0.4074 or 4.074. It is a subtraction of decimals. More one example I will take here.
1.47 or 1.51.
1.47 और 1.51 Now check the before number. What is the first digit? 1. First digit is 1. Before number digits are completed. Then come to the after point. After point first number is 4. First number is 5. Which is the greater number? 4 or 5? 5 is the greater number. So 1.51 is the greater number. Next. Fourth question is 6 or 0.66. 6 or 0.66. It is 6 or 0.6 or 0.66. 6.0 or 0.66. Now compare the before point. 6 before point 0. Before point for 6 only, before point for 0 only. So what is the greater number 0 or 6? 6 is the greater number. So 6.0 is the greater number. You have to remember. Point is the 0 on the value of the 0 pakane number the number value. For example, if I have written 8.0. It is 8 only. If I have written 8.03, then it is 8.303. 8.0 and 8 are the same. And 8.03 and 0 value. Simple, look at 0 and 8.0 and 8 and 0. Okay, then? Next, second bit. Express the following as rupees using decimals. You have to convert. Second bit is express the following as rupees using decimals. Express the following rupees following as then 9 paisa means how to convert by the division. 9 by 1 rupee is equal to 100 paisa. So 9 by 100 gives. In the previous class I said I have explained already how to convert fractional number into a decimal number. Now check the denominator. What do you have in the denominator? In the denominator we have 100. In the 100 how many zeros are there? 2 zeros. So in the numerator after 2 digits we have to keep the point. But in the numerator do we have 2 digits? No. So what you have to do, if the digits are not sufficient, left side of that number you have to write the zeros. How many zeros you have to write? You have to write 10. Now if you write like this, 0. 2 digits, 2 zeros, 2 digits has completed. Next it is. Now it is 0.09. 0.09 rupees, that is. Next, second question is 77 rupees 7 paisa. 77 rupees 7 paisa. Now you can say that 0 rupees 9 paisa. You have to say that 0 rupees 9 paisa. Next, second one is 77 rupees 7 paisa. 77 rupees 7 paisa. Now, it is already in rupees only. Now we have to convert this paisa into rupees. So, same like this only. 77 rupees plus, if you convert, if you want to convert 7 paisa into rupees, then 7 by 100. Same like this only. 1 rupee is equal to 100 paisa. Here also you have to write 1 rupee is equal to 100 paisa. 77 rupees plus, then 7 by 100. How we will get the line by converting it to fractions? 0.07. Then 77 rupees plus this 0 rupees 7 paisa. Add that 77 means like this only. 77 rupees. After point there is no value for the 0. So it will become 0.77. Then it is 77 rupees 77 paisa. So 77 rupees. Keep like this. 2.35 paisa. Then 2 rupees 35 paisa you will get. 2.35 paisa. How to convert paisa into rupee? By the using decimals means you have to divide with 100. 1 rupee is equal to 100 paisa. So 2.35 paisa means here you have to come divide with 100. 235 divided by 100. 1 2 2 0 after 2 digits, so it is 2.35. You can say that 2 rupees 35 paisa. 2 rupees 35 paisa. Otherwise 3.5 paisa. So in exercise 5 up to 2nd bit is your homework. 3rd, 4th, 3rd bit and remaining 8 bits I'll explain in the next class. Up to here, if you have any doubts, ask me. I'll explain again. Complete your homework up to here.